Hello students, these are the glossaries what you have to write down in FNB. The first word is discrimination. Discrimination is when we do not treat people equally or with respect due to prejudice. Next one is violation, when someone forcefully breaks the law or rule openly and shows disrespect, we say that he or she has committed a violation. Next one is sexual harassment. Sexual harassment refers to physical or verbal behavior that is of sexual nature and against the wishes of women. Next, we are having violence against the woman. Violence against the woman means murdering, torturing, beating, hurting, discriminating women. Next, women's movement. A movement to awaken women of their rights. Last one we are having stereotype. When we believe that people belonging to the particular group like religious, economic, regional communities are bound to have certain fixed characteristics or can only do a certain type of work, we call them as stereotype. So these are the words what you have to write down in FNB. Rather than the words which are given in the end of the chapter, that also you have to write. If you are finding out similar one, don't write. The new which is not in this list, you have to write down that glossary in the FNB.
So from here we are going to start chapter number 5 from civics, that is Woman Change the World. This is term 1's chapter, but we have included it in the PA 2 syllabus. So the worksheet what you are having in the term 1, please tear it off or just unstaple it and attach it with the PA 2 worksheet. So I want this chapter's worksheet in PA 2 worksheet. Attach it with it. Okay, so here we start. Woman changes the world. In the previous chapter we saw how women's work in the home is not recognized as work, that is being devalued. We also read about doing household work and taking care of family members is a full-time job and there are no specific hours at which it begins or ends. So in this chapter we will look at the work outside the home and understand how some occupations are seen to be more suitable for men than for women. We will also learn about how women struggle for equality. Getting an education was and still is one way in which new opportunities were created for women. This chapter will also briefly trace the different types of efforts made by the women's movement to challenge discrimination in more recent years. So in the last chapter we have understood about the woman's condition inside the home, what kind of work she is doing, and the work what is being done by her that is completely devalued, and even she was not paid for the long hours work what she is doing, and the equal respect she is not getting, the equality what she should get, it is not also being got by her. So about them outside of the home, what kind of work they are doing, and the struggle for the equality they fought, they started a movement, and the opportunity what was being given by the government to the women, that we are going to learn in this chapter. So the challenges what was being faced and the struggles and the movement which were being started by the women, that we are going to learn. Now who does what work? Drawing images of the following, like a farmer, a factory worker, a nurse, a scientist, a pilot, a teacher. Now, a farmer, you always see as men only when we are talking about a farmer. We never see or just imagine a woman as a farmer. A factory worker, again we see as a man as a factory worker. A nurse, yes, nurse, if we imagine, most probably we just imagine the woman, because a woman is the gender who is taking care, and that in naturally it is inbuilt because she is learning it from the her childhood. That we also learn in the previous chapter, like from childhood only she is given the utensils and the doll to play with, because this is her future role. So nurse is also taking care of the patients. So this careness or taking care of someone, it is the duty of most probably the woman. So nurse, the job of nurse is always opted by the woman. So as a nurse, we always imagine the woman. And a scientist, here also most probably we imagine the man as a scientist. A pilot, yes, again men. A teacher, both the genders, because most probably we are seeing both the genders working in this school. And most probably also you can find more teachers by which gender? By the women's gender. Why? Because again, taking care of looking after the needs of children, to understand it better way, to understand the children or students in better way, that is most probably, this role is being most probably done by the women. So preference to the female teacher is more given to the teaching field. But yet you can see many of the teachers as a male also. Like for maths, obviously always we find out the male teachers, and subjects like English, science, for that most probably, and for Hindi you will find out the women's teacher. So here when we count out the ratio, most of the job is being done by the men compared to the women. See what images your class drew by filling in the table below and add up the number of male and female images separately for each occupation. That we have already done. Are there more images of men than women? So what would be the answer? Yes, because compared to the woman, more images we have seen that is related to the men only, because that kind of work is being done by men or male. In what kind of job were there more images of men than women? So what was the workers like? Hard working farmer, factory working, that is okay. Again the farmer, scientist, the outgoing, and just technical logical thinking, and even the pilot, that are all outgoing work. So most probably this kind of work is being done by male. And for female, as we seen that teaching and nursing, this would be her role. We are imagining themselves as like that. Have all the nurses been drawn as female? Why? Now that already I have given, because they are taking care of much better than the male. They know the requirement and they can nourish, and they could be more kind compared to the male, to the patients. Are there fewer images of female farmers? Yes. Again, why we are thinking so? Because for farming or for cultivating anything, there is a hard work throughout the day. You have to work in the field, sowing, then plowing. So this kind of work is always we imagine that is being done by the male. But it is not like that in one condition also, like the women are also working in the field, they are also plowing, they are also sowing the seeds, and even in the harvesting, they are helping out the male. So the work which is being done by male, it is also being done by the woman, but they are not valued for that, or we couldn't imagine the woman doing such kind of hard work. So that is always meant for male. Here you can see the picture, and below see the left hand side what it says. 83.6% of working women in India are engaged in agricultural work. Their work includes planting, weeding, harvesting and threshing, as I said. Yet when we think of farmer, we only think of a man. So this is our imagination. And just what we have learned from the childhood, that all hard works or the physical work is being done by male. So that, because that mindset we are having, we always prefer the male as a farmer. So Rosie ma'am class has 30 children. Here is the ratio what the children has filled up. She did same exercise in our class, and what was the result? Teacher mainly 5 and female 25. So out of the 30, the 25 goes to the female. They think like that. See the mindset of here of the students. Then next we are having farmer. Male preference is given more than 0 to the female, because most probably we never imagine farmer as a female. Then factory worker, again 25 to the female. Nurse 0 here. You can compare the farmer and nurse over here. So nourishing work or just taking care of the patient is always being done by female. So we always prefer female as a nurse. Scientist, yes, male 25 and again female 5. Pilot, 27 in male and 3 in female. So from this ratio only we can understand the mindset what we are having. Now fewer opportunities and rigid expectations. A lot of children in Rosie ma'am's class drew women as nurse and men as army officers. The reason they did this, because they feel that outside the home too, women are good at only certain jobs. So this is our thinking, and because of this our thought, we just put women in the certain categories like nurses and women, and men in the like factory workers and army officers and like that. So we think that the women are only having certain jobs to do. That is being done by her only. So for example, many people believe that women make better nurses because they are more patient and gentle. As I said, they are very kind to the patients compared to the male. This is linked to the woman's role within the family. Similarly, it is believed that science requires a technical mind, and girls, women are not capable of dealing with the technical things because they are always considered as emotional fools, or they are more sentimental compared to the men. So all kind of technical mind is said that is with the male only. So they are not opting the options like to become scientist or to become a pilot. So science requires more technical mind, and that is with the men. Because so many people believe in these stereotypes, many girls do not get the same support that boys do not do to study and try and train to become doctors and engineers. In most families, once girls finish school, they are encouraged by their families to see marriage as their main aim in life. Now why it is happening? Because of the stereotype thinking. Means, what do you mean by stereotype? One set of thinking that we always think about a group, a religion, or an economic or regional community. So here, to one particular gender, always we are having a certain kind of that it could be done by her only, or male can do this kind of hard or physical work could be only done by the men. So this is the stereotype thinking. We assume it and we just look after the person or the group like that only. So that is called as stereotypes. So because of this stereotype thinking, we always think that the nurses and teacher would be played more easily by the women, and men could be a pilot or a factory worker. Now why the women are not able to do, or why the girls are not able to become engineer or doctor? Because they are not supported by the families, they are not encouraged by the families. Because mainly women, after getting into certain age, they are always preferring them to get married, and their main aim is to get married only. So they have to look after the family, they have to take care of the children, they have to cook, they have to just clean up the houses, all household work she has to do. So why to learn or why to opt the degree courses, or why to opt the profession which is most probably chosen by the men? Because after the marriage, she is not going to work. She is going to look after house and family. So her main aim is this. So she is not being encouraged by the families. Breaking stereotypes. So there are certain many cases in front of us. We already read about, we are knowing about. Here one kind of case it is being given. This is stereotype breaking. As you can see in the picture, one woman, she is running the train. Engine driver are men. Most probably we can see that engine driver are always men. But 27-year-old Lakshmi Lakhra from a poor tribal family in Jharkhand has begun to change the things. She is the first woman engine driver for the Northern Railways. Lakshmi's parents are not literate, but they struggled and overcame many hardships to make sure their children got an education. Lakshmi studied in government school. Even in the school, Lakshmi helped with the housework and did odd jobs. She studied hard and did well, and then went on to get a diploma in electronics. She then took the railway and board exams and passed it on her first attempt. So here you can see her family's hard work, and her family has supported her well. She struggled, went to government school. She was doing certain odd jobs, and here she was taken the degree course, diploma in electronics. Most probably electronics course is being also opted by the men only. But here she has broken that stereotype, and she went for the diploma of electronics. Later on, she passed out the railway board exam at the first attempt. Now Lakshmi says, I love challenges, and the moment somebody says it is not for girls, I make sure I go ahead and do it. Lakshmi has had to do this several times in her life, when she wanted to take electronics, when she rode motorcycles at polytechnic, and when she decided to become an engine driver. So she was loving when she was given a challenge that and was being said like this could not be done by the woman or girls. So she liked the work when she got the challenges, and she succeeded in that challenges also, like riding a motorcycle. Again, if we imagine, so we always imagine the men or male on motorcycle. So she has rode the motorcycles also. She became an engine driver, and she passed out the diploma in electronics. So all these things are being done by men. Her philosophy is simple: as long as I am having fun without harming anyone, as long as I doing well and helping my parents, why should I not lead a lifestyle of my choice? So here that we have to understand, and the simplest thing what she said, that is one person's choice what to become or what to not. No person should be said that this certain kind of work is only meant for you. The thing that we are learning from the childhood, we are hearing it from our families, we are hearing it from our surrounding elders, youngers, from the society members. So we just opt the things, or whatever the suggested thing, we just follow and we grow up like that. So that kind of mindset from childhood, that is being set up from the childhood itself. Why? Because of our families and the surrounding, the society. We used to follow such things. So that should not be done. The decision should be always within your hand. You should not, like she said, we should not harm anyone. We should have whatever work we are doing, we should have fun with that without harming anyone. And the choice should be yourself or ourselves. It is important to understand that we live in a society in which all children face pressure from the world around them. Sometimes these come in the form of demand from adults. At other times, they can just be cause of unfair teasing by our own friends. Boys are pressurized to think about getting a job that will pay a good salary. They are also teased and bullied if they do not behave like other boys. You may remember that in the class 6th book, you read about how boys at an early age are encouraged not to cry in front of others. So this behavior, what we are learning, that is, as I said, that is we are learning from our childhood, like boy should not cry, and if she is if he cries, then he is being teased by the family or by friends or by the people of society, like just saying the sentences like the boys do not cry, they are tough. So the crying part is always related to the woman. So the boys are tough, then women should not laugh loudly. So this kind of things are being suggested, and we constantly follow that. If we are not doing such things, what happens? We are being teased and we are being bullied to not doing such kind of thing, because everyone in surrounding is doing the same thing. If we are separate from them, if we opt the other options, of if we do not follow certain kind of thing, what will happen? They will tease, they will bully us. So we stop doing certain things and we behave what the other boys are doing or what the other girls are doing. We start doing such kind of things. So here we are having the story related to the same topic that we are going to cover in the next video. Till here, whatever we have completed, you have to complete the worksheet by your own words. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you.